if you want to know how to prove to a non-Muslim about the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about Quran is the word of God, there are video cassettes available in which I've given a talk, is the Quran God's word? And there I've proved logically that the Holy Quran is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, irrespective whether he be a Hindu or a Christian or an atheist or a scientist, he'll be convinced with the answer. Now even prove the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The moment you go home and do the homework, you become a master in that answer. So now you can answer to your non-Muslim friend about the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about how to prove the Holy Quran is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you tell him, don't have alcohol, he says, what's the proof? Go home, do your homework. Now you are a master in three answers. In this way, you yourself will increase your knowledge. Even if you know one verse, you have to propagate it. There is no excuse for anyone for not doing dawah. It's compulsory. So the Muslims will say, let's see, speaking about Islam to non-Muslims, yes, we should do it, but first we should speak to the Muslims. We should make the Muslims better Muslims. We should first make the Musliman pakka Musliman, and then we should do dawah. But no, I do agree that we should also do Islam. Islam means improving the Muslims, giving more knowledge about Islam to the Muslims. I do agree we should do Islam also. But if anyone says that first we will make the Musliman pakka Musliman and then do dawah, that time will never come. It will never come. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he could not convert. He could not change his own family members. He could not change his uncle. Do you think you are better than him? He did his job. He delivered the message. The Quran says in Surah Aisha, chapter number 88, verse number 21. It says, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّ مَانْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. Your job is to deliver the message. Changing hearts is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But your job is to do zikr. Is to deliver the message. But some people say, no, first we'll make the Musliman pakka Musliman, and then we will speak to the non-Muslim. That time will never come. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the farewell pilgrimage, he said that had every one of you, and there were more than 1,10,000 sahabas, more than 110,000 sahabas were present there, he asked them that did you received the message, and all of them unanimously said, Beshak, we did. We did receive the message. Then our beloved Prophet said that all those who are present here, deliver it to those who are not present here. And believe me, more than 100,000 of the Sahabas were buried outside Arabia. For what? For making Musliman pakka Musliman? No, for doing dawah. To deliver the message to the non-Muslims. Our beloved Prophet, he sent messages. He asked the scribes to write down messages about Islam to the non-Muslim kings of Persia, of Byzantine, various kings, many of which also tore off that letter, which contained verses of the Holy Quran. Do you think our Prophet was wrong? Because there were many people in Medina who were yet not perfect Muslims. Our beloved Prophet said that there were many Muslims who did not come for the compulsory congregational prayer. It's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari. Many Muslims who did not come for the compulsory congregational prayer, for the Jummah Salah. He said, I feel like burning their houses. That means there were Muslims who were not perfect. But yet, our beloved Prophet said, give the message to the non-Muslims. It has to be simultaneous. Dawah and Islam should be simultaneous. You can't say, I will first make all the Musliman pakka Musliman and then do dawah. That time will never come. We want to give excuse for not doing dawah. We say, see, when our own deeds aren't good, hamare amal, our own deeds, they aren't good, so how can we speak to the non-Muslim? They'll point a finger at us. They will tell us, you Muslims, you are good. What are you coming and giving us the message? What are you delivering the message to us? You Muslim, you yourself aren't good. So therefore, first we'll make the Muslims good and then speak to non-Muslim. Believe me, that time will never come. I pose the question to such people and I tell them that I want to ask the question, are you better or those Christian missionaries who come from Europe and America? They come and they drink alcohol. Do you drink alcohol? They say no. They do adultery. Do you do adultery? They say no. Who's better? We are better. With all the defects, these Christian missionaries who are wine drinkers, who are alcoholics, who are adulterers, still they are converting hundreds and thousands of people. Why can't you do? They have the falsehood with them, with all the defects, with all the ill habits. Yet, they are able to convert thousands of people. What's the problem with you? Do you think you are worse than them? When they can do the job, why can't you? You know why? Because to speak to a Muslim is very easy. If I tell a Muslim, let's say offer the salah, even if he does not pray, he will not hit me, he will not slap me, he will not abuse me. Why? Because he's a Muslim. It's easy to tell to a Muslim, "Arey bhai, dahi rakho, keep up here." Why? Even if he does not keep, he will not abuse me. "Arey bhai, go and pass." Why? Even if he does not pass, he will not repel. But if I tell to a non-Muslim, I'm afraid that it may backfire. You want to do the easy job. Therefore, it is compulsory for everyone to do both Dawa and Islam. And believe me, there are some people who quote the Quran to say Dawa is not required. And they say, it's mentioned in the Quran, لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَدِّينَ, that to you is your way and to me is mine. Therefore, Quran clearly says, let them follow their way of life. Why should we interfere? These people, they are misquoting the Quran. They are quoting a verse of the Holy Quran out of context. What they are quoting is from Surah Kafirun, chapter 109, verse number 6. But for the context, you have to refer to all the 6 verses, which says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ وَلَا أَنَا عَابِدٌ مَا عَبَدْتُمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينِ, which means that say to those who reject faith, you worship not that which I worship. I will not worship that which you worship. You will not be worshipping that which I want you to worship, nor will I worship that which you worship. To you is your way and to me is mine. First, deliver the message. After he rejects the faith, then tell him that I will not worship that which you worship and you will not worship that I worship. But first, the question of rejecting the faith comes only after you deliver the message. It does not come before delivering the message. After you deliver the message, and then if he rejects the message, then after trying your level best, then you can tell him to use your way to meet mine. That is not the first resort, that is the last resort. That is the last resort, not the first. Some people say, the Quran says that life after deen, there is no compulsion religion. So therefore, why should we bother with the non-Muslims? We should not compel them. You know, again they are misquoting the Quran. They are putting out of context. What they are referring to is a verse from the Holy Quran, from Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 256. And it does say, La yakrah fi ddeen, there is no compulsion religion. But read the complete verse. The complete verse says, truth stands out clear from error. If you reject the evil, and if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will crack the most trustworthy handhold. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you from darkness into the light. And if you hold the hand of the Satan, he will take you from light to darkness. Complete the full verse. Complete the full context. Don't just say, La yakrah fi ddeen, there is no compulsion religion. Also say, truth stands out clear from error. Present the truth. After you present the truth of Islam, you don't have to force him. You don't have to convert anyone at the point of the sword or the point of the cannon. It is